Hello, my sweet child. I'm showing Flux Context in Draw Things. Draw Things is the image and video generator for Mac and iOS. It's free on the app stores and can be downloaded from drawthings.ai. Draw Things. Draw Things. Flux Dev Context is an edit model. There are a few others in this edit category. I see edit Ace Plus Plus, the In Context Loras, and Hydream E1. These are all edit models for making edits to an image. Usually it's side by side, a reference on one side, and an in paint subject on the other. Flux Context is much easier. We're not in painting, there's nothing extra to do. Context is a full model, so load it in the model manager. We can start editing the image that's on the canvas just by prompting. The official guide says to give an instruction as the prompt. Use clear verbs like change the color or add this and remove that or replace this with that. Just tell the AI what to do. Simple instructions and one thing at a time.
Is a fine tune of Flux Dev. Check the model drop down. Search for context with a K.
At the moment, there are three versions. They're all the same dev fine tune. There's a compressed 5-bit version and the full float 16 exact. If you are editing an image inside a Flux Dev project, Context Dev can swap in. Keep the same parameters and just change the prompt. If you use acceleration, the fast loras seem to work. Try them and see. I'll share my basic parameters without acceleration. Since this is not in painting, we leave strength at 100% text to image. Steps are in the normal range for dev 25 to 35. My text guidance is at 5 and shift at 4. Use your regular Flux sampler. For me, it's DVIM trailing. I've disabled T-cache while I'm editing the images. T-cache could save you time by shaving off unnecessary steps, but I want to keep the renders at the same quality as the reference.
Draw Things.
In addition to pure edits, Context can do style transfer and reimaginings of the original image. You might call that a shuffle or a redux. For a style transfer, the prompt guide suggests starting with use it this style and then fill in the rest with your regular prompt. You can also say use this composition, and we can say things like change the scene to plasticine. Add keep or preserve the features to prevent the image from completely changing character traits and details.
Draw Things.
We can use the eraser tool to mask the area that's allowed to change. Put another way, the rest of the image will be the same.
I'm not adjusting the strength setting, just a pure mask. I don't think in painting is useful here, because Context is very good at keeping faces accurate and adjusting the costumes and removing the backgrounds. The workflow is straightforward when editing the image on the canvas. What we see is what we get. So one instruction at a time.
That lead up to the current one.
Draw Things. Draw Things.
When editing text, the guide says we should use quotes.
not just around the text itself, but around the whole instruction set for the text. So, we'd add the quotes around, change this word to that word. I guess it keeps the instruction focused, but it was easier to use the eraser to mask out the old text.
Erase it away! Draw things! Draw things!
The last feature I'll show is the mood board. It's moved to the new control interface. Find the control layers from the side rail. Here we can view the image on the canvas and any of the other input layers. And at the edge of the layer buttons are smaller menus for each. I don't have a control loaded, so my control manager is left empty. The layer that works with context is the mood board.
Mood board. Draw things.
Another way to work, using reference images, not just editing on canvas. Multiple images can be loaded. It's drag and drop on Mac, and the small context menu can load from photos or files, or from the clipboard. But with each extra image, the memory pressure and the render time is gonna grow.
Geometrically!
One reference image will render twice as long as Flux Dev. Two reference images will render four times as long, and so on. We can leave images in the mood board and temporarily ignore them by setting the individual strengths to zero.
Any image above 0% will contribute equally. It doesn't matter what setting, it's all or nothing. With context, draw things, mood board.
Talk about the mood board, baby.
When we use reference images on a pure white background, these objects can be added to other images seamlessly. A character can be composited from white onto any background. A specific costume can be worn, and the same character can be referenced again and again, changing expression and other details. I've just gotten started, and I'm sure I'll find 100 more uses.
Yeah! Draw things! Draw text!
That's all we have time for. I hope you had a learn. If you think people will find this video helpful, give it a like. And you can subscribe to be notified of the next ones.